Shit! What's going on here?
Time has passed for the weary hero Artyom. The weight of committing genocide on the Dark Ones haunts him from the last game. It is from this pain that drives the character and the player to the finale of the game. From discovering the Red's plan to fight mutated demon-like creatures, the story will grab and will not let go till the end. While there are multiple endings, one ending will stay with you long after the credits roll. 4A Games took the best elements of Metro 23 and shined them to a brilliant finish in Last Light. The controls are tight, fast, and heart-pounding. Choosing to sneak past enemies or go guns blazing like a madman with a death wish are done effectively, and more importantly, they are entertaining. Completionists are not left out in the cold either. Scavenging every nook and cranny will reward players with additional story info, ammo, weapons, mods, and more. Thinking of mods, players can outfit their weapons to how they play, making sure to add a nice bit of customization to the game. 4A Games even managed to blend different forms of genre into one fairly cohesive game. From action to exploration to RPG elements to even bits of horror, there's a little bit of everything in the game. However, gamers expecting an open world will be disappointed as this follows the same fully detailed yet linear environment path as the last game. While each aspect of the story and the world was beyond fun, there are moments which felt out of place. One in particular comes to mind. You have finally caught up with the Reds, and during one of their conversations you're trying to listen in on, you find yourself with a stripper. The Reds walk away without knowing you were there, and the game gives you the option for a lap dance. I can see a place for strippers in this world, but after overhearing a deadly plot against the Metro, felt out of place and out of character. Shit's hitting the fan, the world could come to an end. I think I will have a lap dance to ease the nerves. Unlike most post-apocalyptic games where everything is drab, dark, and damp, Last Light manages to give color and variety to every level. Zones dynamically alter in shades and hues, immersing the player deeper into the game, adding that bit of character. The AI gives a good job of keeping players on their toes. In harder difficulties, the enemies must be handled with stealth for as long as you can keep hidden. This can be great for some, but those looking for a near-invincible juggernaut of a character that can soak damage like a sponge, you won't find it with this game. The voice acting adds another level of authenticity to the game that draws the player in. While a few lines of dialogue will appear out of place, and certain bugs will force the enemy to repeat lines to the point of annoyance, these minor grievances are nothing compared to the level of interesting characters you stumble upon through your journey into the Metro, from side characters to main characters to just off-the-wall ambience. All of it works well, if not stellar.
Congratulations, you're a mutant.
No, no, please!
Do the garbage shoot!
For any fan of the original or an active FPS gamer, anything under hard will be too easy. However, if you pre-order or bought into the $5 Ranger mode, this is the recommended difficulty. With no HUD, enemies reacting with a greater degree of intelligence, and you tack on the scarcity of resources, this is how the game was meant to be played. Sadly, Deep Silver, the current publisher, decided to follow through with THQ's money grab at forcing players to pay for harder difficulty. Should Deep Silver have given players this difficulty at the start for free? Yes. Does this hurt the game without it? No, the game is still worth you shelling out the cash to experience this amazing game. It's just very disappointing that the current publisher decided to follow the old publisher's route while still on Twitter saying that, well, and that was THQ's fault. Guys, if you're going to say something like that, follow through and just give players what they want and give it for free. Like the last Metro, Last Light still has a number of bugs that can stop you from progressing. What I experienced was a few graphical bugs, two times where an NPC who was the only one who could open up the door glitched out on me, and a point where a few items glitched through the wall. Now, I will admit, this is my fault because it's the fault of the game for glitching, but it's my fault for being too carefree because there was a moment where once those items glitched through, I didn't have any ammo, and I was pretty much pissed off royally. My fault for being an idiot and being a little too carefree and willy-nilly with my supplies and ammo. In the end, Last Light succeeds on all its major strengths. Any fan of the series would be missing out on an awesome game if you didn't buy it. Those looking to jump into the series will also find something worth grabbing onto and just holding and experiencing. The replayability on this game is, well, story-wise, not too big. There are multiple endings. Going back through, trying different tactics, trying different weapons, different customizations, trying different difficulties. Now, whether or not you should buy in for Ranger mode, that is entirely up to you. Do I think that Deep Silver should have given us that for free? Yes, they should have. But if you don't think that $5 worth it, at least buy the game. That is definitely worth the price of admission completely, without question. And with 4A games constantly updating and patching the game, all my little grievances will eventually be gone and just out in the wind. And then when you factor in the idea that they have DLC, story-driven DLC, coming into the game, I'm very, very curious to see what they will take in direction for this game, how they plan on proceeding the story, where they plan on jumping off, because there are a number of little things along the way of the game in the story that will give good starting points if you decide to go different characters or the main character or whatever you plan on doing. Hell, I would even love to see it from the point of view of a Dark One. That would be awesome. But that's just me. Anyway, guys, hope you liked the video, and I will catch you next time. When you're this good, nothing else matters. Well.